One of the most important goals of space exploration is the search for life outside the Earth. Could we have succeeded with Curiosity finding traces of organic matter on Mars? Join us today as we talk about this in more detail. It wouldn't take a genius to know that Mars has been a popular pick on sci-fi films. Who can forget Schwarzenegger's Total Recall? Besides that, there's also Matt Damon's The Martian in 2015, John Carter in 2012, The Red Planet in 2000, and the most recent one, 2019's Ad Astra. If you're an avid viewer of these types of films, I'm sure you may have wondered if these scenarios are possible at some point. If you are a longtime fan of this channel, you know how much we love to talk about Mars. And who wouldn't? I mean, this planet is practically our Earth's sister. And if there's anything that we can say, that this is the best candidate in our solar system to hopefully host our species in the future, it would certainly be the red planet. To recall, Mars is practically similar to Earth in various numbers of ways. We both have an atmosphere, although in terms of composition, they are practically different. Our rotation speeds are practically the same. It's just that Mars moves 2.7% slower. So with all that's been going on with Mars, what could probably be the most exciting news we could hear about it? New craters? Finding a sufficient atmosphere? Well, how about finding something that would indicate the possibility of life existing at some point? Does that do anything for you? I'm sure it does. But before you go hiding underground into your bunkers and go panic buying for supplies and weapons to prepare for an impending invasion, I'm obliged to calm you down and tell you, no, we won't see those aliens with popped eyes and huge brains with no skulls, or even some species of ET from Mars anytime soon. I know that's quite a bummer, but I promise you this story will be interesting. The news of finding evidence of life possibility of Mars isn't entirely something new. In 1996, the then US President Bill Clinton presented to the press a sample from Antarctica discovered by Alan Hills in 1984. The rock named ALH84001 debris was suspected to have ejected from Mars. And what's special about it was that it contained traces of fossils of what appeared to be microbes. Sadly, at that conference, the press wasn't interested, and Clinton was asked a more trivial question, such as, where did he get his tie? Plebs, am I right? Our planet has been sending expeditions to study Mars ever since 2001. In fact, the whole world mourned when the Opportunity rover sent its last transmission back in 2018 after covering almost 45 kilometers and discovering a lot of useful information, one of which is the discovery of traces of water activity on Mars. However, there are still a lot of expeditions on the red planet working just as hard as our Oppie. For instance, in 2012, the Curiosity rover landed on Mars with a specific goal in mind. Or its programming, rather. The rover landed on the Gale Crater, a land depression spanning about 154 kilometers in diameter. What's special about this is that astronomers strongly suspect that this crater might have been a dried-up lake, since there were indicators there of ancient water activity. And as we know from biology, when there's water, there's probably life. This is exactly what Curiosity's mission was: to perform some scraping and some small digging on the soil at Gale and hopefully find something there that would indicate life or the possibility of it. And in 2018, Curiosity transmitted promising results. What it found is one key factor in determining life: organic molecules. So let's explore a bit about organic matter, in case the previous sentence didn't really do anything for you. When we say something is organic, what it simply means is that it is related to something living or to life. In a more technical sense, organic molecules are compounds paired with carbon to form a new one. So what's so special about carbon? Well, all life here on Earth, more specifically, life as we humans understand it, is a result of carbon compounds combining to more complex forms. Specifically speaking, when something is alive, it is made up of carbon compounds, and quite expectedly, it is bound to emit or release carbon compounds. Can you put things together at this point? I bet you already can. But in case you still haven't, the organic molecules found on Mars signify the presence of life at some point in its history. And let's stress that word out for a bit, shall we? Take note that we used the word signify. We want to be careful as to not get the hype extremely above our heads and out of control. What the findings indicate are simply a possibility, although it doesn't necessarily verify life, but still a possibility. Of course, there's more to add to this later on, but at least for the moment, let's take it one step at a time. So we found organic compounds on Mars, but it doesn't necessarily imply that there was or there currently is life on it. I mean, organic molecule production is not an exclusive process. There are other means to make this besides having them emitted by living things. They can also be made through energy from light and heat, to name a few. One key compound that astronomers have discovered that might indicate life on Mars was the presence of methane in the atmosphere. Now, this isn't new, as ESA's Mars Express Orbiter first verified this back in 2004, but of course, that only sets the gears turning on the interest about it. In fact, Mars's atmosphere was detected to have 60 ppvb, or parts per billion volume. What Curiosity discovered was the amount of methane in the vicinity of the Gale crater varies in a seasonal manner. Specifically speaking, the rover detects the highest levels of the gas at summer phases, while it detects the lowest at winter time. This indicates that there is some kind of activity under the crater that causes it to freeze in winter and melt and evaporate in summer. Does this mean there is life underneath the crater? Well, not exactly. As we have mentioned earlier, organic molecule production can occur even without the help of biological life. However, the point of controversy here is that the amount of methane measured somehow appears to replenish itself. How do we know it gets replenished? Well, the nature of methane, and of course all things, doesn't really make it permanent. In fact, the light rays from the sun will eventually break down molecules of methane after several hundreds of years. And this is not the case for Mars. If there are tiny Martians watching this right now from under the surface of Gale, we would love to hear from you. Send us a sign that you're there. Another thing to consider is if the amount of methane in the crater wasn't caused by biological processes, it could, on the other hand, indicate extraordinary geological processes going on from the planetary interior, which is equally as interesting as finding life because it will lead us to more information about the red planet. This is exactly the mission of NASA's InSight lander, which landed on Mars in November 2018. Which can dig up to 5 meters to test for geological activity. I know we've come a long way in the story, but the tale of finding organic molecules didn't end with methane. Curiosity also found organic molecules that are more complex than methane. Upon digging the Gale crater, the rover stumbled to mudstones that might have been billions of years old. These rocks are sedimentary and are most commonly found submerged in bodies of water, such as at the bottom of oceans, lake floors, lagoons, or even rivers. And most importantly, a great place to store and grow organic compounds. Remember how scientists initially thought the crater used to be a lake? These rocks attest to that hypothesis. So how exactly do these mudstones become integral to finding organic molecules on Mars? The process goes like this. One of the core functions of the Curiosity rover is to be able to dig at a certain depth and effectively take a few samples. Through the help of the rover's very own analysis suite called SAM, or Sample Analysis at Mars, the samples were heated up to 500 degrees Celsius, so that the organic molecules will be released in the form of gas. Sounds like an easy task, doesn't it? Not entirely. Some large organic molecules are not that easy to vaporize due to the presence of sulfur, and when the presence of this element makes it much harder to heat up. However, despite the challenge, the rover still managed to isolate organic molecules from the mudstone, which included benzene, toluene, small carbon chains such as propane and butane, and most importantly, the one that we're going to talk about more, thiopenes, and a few isotopes of it. So what exactly is it that makes thiopenes special? Before we dive more into that, let's talk a bit about thiopenes here on Earth. Here, these compounds are commonly found on coals and oil crudes, and is most generally used for argochemicals and pharmaceuticals. Besides, the previously mentioned thiopenes can also be found in white truffles, which is a really expensive and familiar ingredient for those who love exquisite culinary experiences. Okay, does this mean that there are Martian mushrooms growing on the top of Gale Crater as we speak? Well, right around the time it was discovered, not entirely. See, the samples which Curiosity took came from a place that can really be easily tampered. The rover can only dig up to 5 centimeters. Do you have a key for your door in your pocket? Try to bury that to the ground. That's about the best depth it dug on. Not really that much, is it? The compounds that are stored at a depth of this shallow are strongly influenced by radiation from outer space, either from the sun or from any other sources. Add to that the various other compounds in the mudstone that could have heavily affected the organic ones, it is possible that the thiopenes they have found might really be shredded parts of larger organic molecules in the crater. It's just that they haven't dug deep enough to be more certain about it. We can also attribute the presence of the organic compounds to cosmological processes that happen frequently in our solar system. For instance, asteroids or meteors could, at some point, have reached the Gale Crater, which may have been carrying organic substances, which later got embedded into the soil in the crater. As outrageous as it sounds, this is also a valid possibility. After all, this is how a huge part of the water in our planet came here. As servants of science, we can't just throw any possibility out of the window. We have to be open to a lot of possibilities. But all hope is not lost. Part of the InSight lander's mission is to lower down a heat probe into the mudstones in Gale and attempt to discover whether the large organic molecules where the thiopene may have came from. Moreover, at around the start of the second half of 2020, Russia's Rosalind Franklin will bring up the Mars Organic Molecule Analyzer, or MOMA for short, to aid the investigation of the compounds. Besides that, a recent publication on the Astrobiology Journal presented results that may increase the excitement on the research and verification of organic molecules on Mars. According to the paper, the correlations found in the analysis of the sample studies suggests that it might have been biological processes that resulted in the presence of the organic compounds found on the mudstones. However, it's still not mushrooms that might have done it, and they're leaning towards inferring that it might have been a result of bacterial processes. I guess Martian white truffle oil is still a long way away ahead in the future, but our astronomers are strongly motivated to find the answers as soon as we can. Because of these results, the scientists recommended to bring back samples specifically containing carbon and sulfur isotopes, as these are indicators of organisms sustaining themselves. If we can find traces of what the organisms treat as their food, we inch closer towards verifying the existence of life. I know some of you are bummed out to find out that we're still far ahead towards finding life on Mars, but think of it this way. The organic compounds from the Gale Crater indicates that this place held up the necessary ingredients for life to have possibly existed. And who knows, maybe life did exist or is currently existing on Mars, but just not in the way that we know it. If you watched the movie Evolution back in 2001, the aliens there were nitrogen-based organisms. And it's a strong possibility not just for Mars, but for other places as well. As astronaut Neil Armstrong once said, "One small step for man is a giant leap for mankind. We just need to hold on there and keep exploring." To end this episode, let me pass on a question to you, my dear viewers. Assuming we are to find life on Mars, would they be of similar composition as us? Are they going to be carbon-based, or are they going to be based on something else? Do you think we're closer to finding extraterrestrial life? Let us know what you think. Leave your answers in the comment section below. You know, one of the pastimes I enjoy is reading what you wrote. I hope there's a way to show you how grateful we are for you viewing. If you like this episode, don't forget to press the like button to keep us going. If you like content like these showing up on your feeds, why don't you click on that subscribe button and the bell icon too, so that you get notified whenever something new comes up. We release new videos almost every day. See you soon. Stay insanely curious.